Second and 10 here in the third quarter of Super Bowl 56. Going to run the toss here to Harris. And he's got room. There he goes, right side. And all the way in. Touchdown, New England. Damian Harris, 60 yards. And the Patriots have regained the lead in the second half of this Super Bowl.
I guess when you look back on it, it was just a matter of time until he popped a big one like that. And, you know, at halftime, you and I discussed it. They had done a nice job on him in the first half. But there were a couple of occasions where it felt like he might wiggle out of traffic and take it to the house. Finally here in the second half, that got done.
Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. And this is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Tom Brady leads the offense out for their next possession. He's likely still kicking himself from the interception last drive that wound up leading to a go-ahead score.
And he's going to assume all that came with that one, all right? That's all on him, but he also knows he's got to erase it from his mind and get back out there. This drive, very important.
Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield, incomplete.
And those two just haven't been in sync thus far. They've done a nice job against him, but still, with his talent, you would expect them to have more completions to him in this game.
Buying time to his left. Now he'll let it go on the run. Deep left side. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
They've been trying and trying, but they haven't sacked him yet. He's been able to get away and make plays. Tried to make another one downfield right there, but to no avail. They'll have to keep up the pursuit, though, and not let him get hot.
An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
Now he'll let it go deep right side. And on it. Able to connect, incomplete. Give them credit, they took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down. Here's Bradley Pinion now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And they're going to fake it from deep in their own territory. And this is caught, and the fake will work. He's going to have a first down.
Okay, that was a fake punt, and it was successful throwing the football. I know you threw the football in your past off of a fake.
Yeah, but unsuccessful back in my high school days. Old Tim Jones dropped it, hit him right in the numbers. But I'll tell you what, these guys, they love this opportunity, don't they? A chance to get involved?
They certainly do, and many of them were quarterbacks or big-time players when they were in high school and college. So to get back doing what they did before, always fun.
Now Brady again. He'll buy some time right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And that is incomplete.
While the ultimate result was an incomplete pass, they sure look like a well-coached team because once he got outside of the pocket, the scramble rules come into effect. And a lot of the guys who ran deep routes, they come back closer to the line of scrimmage. And the running back usually runs a check down. He took it deep, and they gave it a big shot and came up unsuccessful.
Third quarter of the biggest spectacle in sport, the Super Bowl. Thanks for joining us, everybody. Second and 10. Sliding out of the pocket. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And Brady going to be intercepted a third time. Devin McCourty picks it off. And the Pats are going to get the football back as time will run out in this third quarter of play. One quarter remains here in the Super Bowl. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. The Pats at the line, ready to go. And the tension ratcheting up all around. A one-score game, fourth quarter of the Super Bowl. This is what you folks came for. Every play with the potential to win or lose a title as they look to drain some time off this clock. Under four to go now as they come up on second down. Looking to throw. Jones completes it to Aguilar. He's at the 30. 10. Touchdown, Patriots. Nelson Aguilar. His second touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Pats are starting to pull away in the fourth quarter of this Super Bowl. They have to love seeing that from their young quarterback here in the fourth quarter, able to further that lead with a touchdown pass.
He didn't go turtle, did he? And you know what I mean by that. I had an old coach used to say all the time, hey, when we have a lead late, don't just tuck in and try and ride it out. Go out and play and extend the lead. And that's what he did.
Now Folk for the extra point. And this one gives his guys a 12-point lead. The long touchdown pass gets him six on a very, very tidy two-play drive that time. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. And this will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. Again, we see Tom Brady and the Bucs set to take over. With his guys trailing here in the fourth, he can ill afford a repeat of the interception that ended the last drive.
Yeah, you're two scores down. You take it upon yourself now to play perfect or near-perfect football if you want to get your team back into the game. But it's also tough to do.
And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception.
Today, from TIAA Bank Field in Jacksonville, Florida, this is Madden Football on EA Sports.
The veteran kicker Mason Crosby set to do the honors here. And off we go from Jacksonville. Jamal Agnew now to return it. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. This is James Robinson. He'll wind up getting a yard on the game's first play at second down.
No doubt about it. Really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
Here's Robinson again on second down. Takes this to the 27. Give him 4 yards.
In today's NFL, you hear all the time about stretching the field and creating space in order to run plays. A toss play will help accomplish that because now you're pushing a defense to chase you all the way to the edges and to the sideline. That's a nice run, probing now early to try and get things done later.
On third down, Lawrence. Now the Packers give him nowhere to go, and they bring him down. So still a scoreless game in the first, but they're going to go for this thing on their own side of the field. Oh, he fakes a spike. And he's brought down. Can't do anything with a football. It's a sack and a turnover on downs. A surprising move here on the opening drive of the game. And now, boy, the ball's going to go over on downs here inside the 10-yard line. First and goal, a chance for an early statement here on the road. Now Rodgers. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
Steps away to his left. Got a man open, it's Adams. Touchdown, Green Bay. A 7-yard touchdown grab, and the Packers on just 2 plays have taken the lead. So remember now, this was all set up by the stop defensively on fourth down. That's what got them this great field position, and then 2 plays later, they're already in the end zone.
Yeah, partner, funny how it works like that, huh? That's a momentum swing amusement park style. Your defense comes off the field, bouncing, grooving, they're fired up, and it carries over to the other side of the ball.
Rodgers will throw for it. Steps away to the goal line, but it's incomplete. Should have been picked. Probably doesn't matter on a 2-point conversion, but still, as a former DB, you want to grab that ball when you can, don't you?
You certainly do, and don't say it, because I know you're thinking it. Don't say it.
What am I thinking?
You know what I know what you're thinking. Well, if he'd had hands, he'd be playing on offense, right?
That's true. You've said that before. So they went for 2 and failed. They didn't use him on the PAT, but now he boots this one away with a 6-0 lead. To return, here's Agnew. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. So time to see Jacksonville again on offense for the second time here in this game. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave them great field position, turned it to 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down.
Caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain. So now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there. And it's second down. So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Now he dumps this off over the middle. Evades the tackler and now some space. 20. 10, 5, touchdown, Jaguars. James Rapp.